How to use Zoom Breakout Rooms on Mac. Breakout Rooms allow you to split your Zoom meeting on Macbook into up to 50 separate sessions. The meeting host can automatically split the participants of the meeting into this separate session and switch between sessions at any time. Please note, this option is available for now only on PC or laptop. Usually, Zoom Breakout Rooms can be used on any account, free or paid. This option is not activated by default, so you have to set it up to use it. Why should you use it? This option has so many uses that it would take me hours to mention. Imagine you are a teacher and you wish to give the assignment to be worked on groups. This is perfect for this scenario. But let's see how we can use this option. To enable the Breakout Rooms feature, go to zoom.us. Sign in to Zoom web portal. In the navigation from the left menu, click Settings. Navigate to the Breakout Room option. In Meetings, Advanced, if the settings is disabled, click the toggle to enable it. If a verification dialog displays, choose Turn On to verify the change. Note, if the option is gray out, it has been locked at either the group or account level, and you will need to contact your Zoom administrator. Click the checkbox to allow meeting hosts to pre-assign participants to breakout rooms. Now Zoom Rooms on Mac is enabled for your account. But how to use Zoom Breakout Rooms on Mac? Let's start a meeting with a few test users to see how this works. You see here, I have a meeting with 4 people on it. Let me show you how Breakout Rooms works. First, click on the Breakout Rooms option from your Mac on the bottom right. On this pop-up window, you need to specify first how many rooms you wish to have. You can select and add as many as you like. Now, after that, we have 2 options: automatically and manually. If you select automatically, the room will be created automatically and the people will be randomly allocated to the room. This option is useful if you need something random. Please note, if you choose automatically and if you tap on Create Rooms, you will not be able to add a new room after you start. You can also choose manually, which will give you the ability to assign user to a specific room. Let's select manually and click Create Rooms on your Mac. Because we have selected manually, we get to this window. Please note that if you open the rooms, you will not be able to create a new room. So my advice for you is to create an extra room every time, just in case you need it. If you need to create a spare room after you started the room, you will need to recreate all rooms and go through the process again. In every room, you have rename, delete, and also assign user to the room. Let's assign some persons to the first room. Click on Assign and check the checkbox for the person you wish to add. Now let's click a bit on Options. Here we have some very good options. We have the option to move all participants automatically and also the option to allow participants to return to the main session at any time. You can set up a timer for the breakout rooms. If you have something like a 10-minute exercise, you can set up this quite easily here. And the last option is the countdown after the session on breakout rooms. You can specify the number of seconds after the time is finished for the room to close. Let's click on Open All Rooms on Macbook. You can send a message to all participants by clicking Broadcast a Message to All. Now all participants needs to accept the join for the room. Because you are the host, you can join in any room. Click on Join to go to that room. Also, it is possible to receive a message like this: a user has asked for help. This is very useful. You can end the meeting for all, leave meeting, or just leave the room and return to the main meeting. This is how you use breakout rooms on Zoom for Macbook. If this was useful, please like, share, and subscribe. You can also watch more videos from the right. Also, if you have any questions, please ask them in the comments area below.